Hi guys, it's V2 Vengeance with some more World of Tanks content. This time we're looking at a game in my newly bought Waffenträger of E100 that perfectly showcases the advantages and disadvantages of an autoloader. So we are on Winter Himmelsdorf with a pretty good matchmaker, 5 Tartan tanks on each team, and I'm headed for the hill. There are pretty much a lot of allies going for the hill, so 3 75s, 1 Object 268, 1 M46 Pattern in E100, and a Centurion 7-1. I see an A75, but I decided that instead of trying to shoot his commander's cupola, I keep driving. And as you're going to see right now, I'm going to fully use my old commander. So the C100, I know that he just fired, he's on 2325 health. Now with a normal tank with this gun, I would deal to him 560 damage and then I had to pull off. But if I have an autoloader, I can do this. And I just killed an almost full health E100. I spot an M103, I put 2 very bad shots into him. But I just did 2325 damage. And this is why people buy the Waffenträger for. But now I'm reloading, so my huge advantage of the drum just ended. And this is where, if I had a normal tank, I might have been able to change the course of the battle. But because I have an autoloader, I'm just a helpless tank for 60 seconds. And 60 seconds in a game like World of Tanks is a lot, and in a situation like this where my allies desperately need my health, having an autoloader is a disadvantage. It was an advantage at the beginning when I could kill the E100, but right now I'm just loaded, I could fire one more shot into the A75 and I'm dead. So this is a pretty quick episode for today, but I really didn't have time for more because I was at a party, one of my colleagues' anniversary, but I think you can understand it. So yes, the advantages and disadvantages of an autoloader. You can kill one Tartan heavy tank in one drum, but you're going to be helpless for the next 60 seconds. Thanks guys for watching. The next video will be longer, I promise. And have a great day.